Guys, we are officially 7 days out from Xdefiant dropping. I'm so hyped. We've been waiting so long for this game to finally drop. It almost felt like it was never going to drop, and it's finally going to. Now, you guys are probably watching this video probably 2 days after I recorded it, probably. I was supposed to make it yesterday, but I got too tired, to be honest. But they dropped this tweet. So on the 16th, when you guys will probably be seeing this video, they're dropping a launch trailer. The preload starts. The 17th, X Debrief preseason episode. On the 20th, the Battle Pass trailer drops. I'm actually not sure what this X Debrief preseason episode is. Probably just talking about what's going to be in the preseason of the game. But yeah, Battle Pass trailer drops on the 20th. And then on the 21st, the game finally drops. Probably a tips and tricks video, maybe, or maybe another blog post or something like that. Also, the All-Star Series final. The only thing I don't like about this, to be honest, is like, why did they drop? So if you guys don't know what the All-Star Series finals is, or the All-Star Series is, they've basically been running like competitive Xdefiant games with ex-Call of Duty pros. I think Pentagram was in one too, but other than him, all of them were retired Call of Duty pros, I think. And I've been tuning into some of them, watching them on our YouTube channel, see how the game looks competitively. But getting back to this, I don't like that they're dropping that the finals the same day the game is dropping. Nobody's gonna want to watch this shit. Game's out, they're gonna want to play. They should drop this like the day before, like on the 20th, if anything, or even like a week into the game, I feel like. But anyways, regardless, but like I said, I didn't get to record this video the day this tweet dropped, this came out, like I wanted to because I was too tired. But today they released a blog post talking about the matchmaking Xdefiant. We're happy to see there is no skill-based matchmaking in their casual playlist. That's a W. I don't know why COD can't just do this, but it's so nice. Like, I know we already knew that skill-based matchmaking wasn't going to be an Xdefiant, but it's just so nice to know we're not going to have to deal with that shit. I'm not going to read this whole blog post to you guys, but I did find this tweet that basically breaks it down pretty clearly. Yeah, so matchmaking is going to depend on the following factors in casual play: latency, party size, region, input device, platform, and matchmaking is avoided with players that have someone muted. I'm assuming muted as in blocked. Like, if you have a player blocked, you won't match up with them, or you won't find yourself on the same team or opposite team or whatever the hell, I think. And if you scroll down right here, rank play will be based on rank points. And this is all by priority, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, you can see it right here. This is how it's prioritizing each factor. So excited, bro. I'm excited. Until then, we gotta play this bum ass shit. And NW3 is really not a bad game, I'll be honest. I don't hate NW3. It's way better than NW2 from last year. But how are you guys doing, man? It's been a while. It's been years, actually, since I uploaded a YouTube video. I think the last video I uploaded was literally 3 years ago. No cap. And it was a vlog. It wasn't even a gameplay video. I'll be honest with you guys. I don't remember the last time I uploaded a gameplay to my channel. That was an actual like recording. Like, a lot of times with stream clips for a little bit, when I was playing Smash competitively, right? So I don't remember the last time I did a cut comp. And it's crazy because what got me into YouTube back in the day was watching like FaZe's cut comps back in the day from the, you know? And I do want to make a video talking about the FaZe guys too, as well. It's good to be back, bro. I've been so creatively blocked for the longest time, so I'm so glad to just be like, I'm gonna make a video again, man. Like, it's been killing me. What's been pissing me off for the longest time now is basically I work as a full-time social media manager, and I had like 3 jobs past year as a social media manager. I think finding the next best thing, better position and stuff like that. But bro, like, I gotta be honest with you, like, I am so tired of just making content for, now, I don't want to say tired of making content for other people, but I'm mad at myself for neglecting myself. If that makes sense. Because I'm not being creative on my own time, you know, it's been really fucking me a lot. But that also brings us back to Xdefiant, bro. Like, I'm so glad to have a game to grind again. Like, an arcade shooter that's similar to Call of Duty. It's like a fresh version of Call of Duty, if you want to say. There's really no good arcade shooters, bro. And my thing is, like, I like tax shooters and shit, but like, arcade shooters are just my bread and butter, bro. They're just my bread and butter. And I'm just happy to have a game to like, to grind again. The reason why I started making content was because of Call of Duty and stuff, right? I wanted to be a professional Call of Duty player at one point when I was like 16. That was 10 years ago. But that's what got me into content. Eventually I played Smash competitively for a little bit too. That's kind of where I then found my success as a content creator for the first time, when I started making content on TikTok too. That was during my Smash, my competitive Smash era, if you will. What the fuck is this guy doing? When I first gained a little following for myself and everything was when I was playing Smash competitively. And because of like, the goal was still to be to go pro and like Smash and shit, it gave me the motivation to create content still. Even if the content had nothing to do with competing, I had like a niche. But eventually I got burnt out in the game because of COVID and shit. Like during COVID and we couldn't go to tournaments and everything, I kind of got burnt out. And then I found myself back in the Call of Duty community. And I always kept up with the Call of Duty community. It's my home. I love it. To me, there's no better community than a competitive Call of Duty community. And I tried to play Warzone too. I was hoping, yo, maybe my last hurrah as a competitive player might be competitive Warzone. Warzone. Try that out. Warzone is not for me, man. And BRs in general just weren't my thing. But I tried, man. I tried to like it. I got back into the Call of Duty scene, like in Vanguard. And I hate Vanguard. You know, and I tried to play Caldera too. Not like that map at all. I didn't even get the experience Verdansk like you guys. I missed that whole fucking wave Warzone first came out. I'm so pissed about it, to be honest. But then NW2 was coming out, and I was like, all right, Warzone 2 is coming out. So I'm like, okay, fresh start, fresh game. Oh my god, I just got shit on. Fresh game, fresh start. You know, I'm gonna try to compete in this game, but I could not stand Warzone 2. The game just felt so slow and clunky and shit. And then this game comes out and it reverted all the changes in NW3 and everything. But I really liked the big map. And then now it seems like they're only focusing on Resurgence. Then I was like, okay, Rank's gonna come out this year for a big map and everything. I'm gonna play that finally. No. They did a rank Resurgence. I'm like, all right, bro, I can't rely on Warzone anymore. So, anyway, that was a long fucking tangent just to say I'm excited for Xdefiant, man. You know, I'm excited to have a game to just... I know, like, a lot of people want to be, like, variety streamers and stuff and play whatever they want. But, like, bro, it's just so... For me, it's just comforting knowing, like, I just know what I'm going to be streaming that day. And having a game just to constantly focus on and get better. I love that shit. So, I'm taking Xdefiant as a perfect opportunity just to get back to content, man. We're going to be doing cut comms like this. I'm going to do tips and tricks videos, settings videos. There'll be some stream clips, gameplays, all that type of shit. You know, I'm going to try to do, like, almost any and everything that's still within, like, on brand for me, I would say. Cut commentary videos, like, it's what kind of made me want to start YouTube back in the day. It's kind of a one-on-one talking to you guys and stuff like that. And it's kind of therapeutic for me. And I kind of get all my thoughts out. I have a lot of opinions of things too that happen on the internet. And I think for a while I stopped expressing my opinions or thoughts about things. Just because people either get offended so easily or you just can't have a decent conversation with someone on the internet. And it kind of just made me a little anxious to even like say my thoughts either on Twitter or anything. I feel like I need an outlet to kind of express myself again. So I feel like these cut comms would be a good way to kind of just kick back. You guys can chill with me and we can just talk about gaming, talk about current events, rap. I want to talk about the Drake and Kendrick shit. It's anything I want, man. I just want to be able to talk about random shit. Lately, I feel like I've been so in like this block, having this creator's block of just being stuck in like making like content for the algorithm. And I kind of like lost myself in it. I feel like nothing's like authentic to me anymore. I overthink it way too much now. So I just want to have like an outlet just to kind of just make content like this and talk over some gameplay, you know? And I feel like Xdefiant's perfect for that. And there's no skill-based matchmaking. This game pisses me off. I actually have to play this game for a little bit before I even record this video. I played for like hour. I usually get triggered in the beginning of this game for some dumb shit. But yeah, man, I am so excited to be back, bro. I miss having a game to grind. Xdefiant is gonna be that. Now, will I try to play Xdefiant competitively? I don't know, man. I'm old fuck now, man. I'm 26. I would love to. I already joined the competitive Xdefiant Discord, but I don't know, man. I don't know if I could dedicate the time to like a team anymore. I would love to go to tournaments and everything, but like I said, your boy getting up there. I'm 26, but in esports years, I'm a fucking dinosaur. So we'll see. You know, I'm definitely going to be grinding ranked and stuff like that, making content. I think that's my focus going to be going forward and streaming it and everything like that. But I don't know. I think my competitive days might be over, as much as that used to be a driving factor for me to create content. But I just want to talk about random shit, man. And I realize that's another thing. I just got to make content that I enjoy watching. And I enjoy like podcasts are like my favorite things to watch on YouTube. I know people make fun of like Dante or Your Rage for like yapping and shit, right? But I love when streamers go into random ass tangents and start talking about shit. I love podcasts when the topic just gets so random and off tangent. Oh my god, that scared the shit out of me. I'm excited for Xdefiant. I'm excited to be back to making content again. Will I play competitively? I don't know. Maybe I'll fuck around and try to grind for some tournaments. You know, I plan on trying to get really good at the game. I don't know about competing and shit. I would love to. I know I really would. We'll see. I'm excited to be back. I'm trying to shoot for 2 videos a week. I'm gonna try to do like 2 streams on TikTok and 2 streams on Kick. If you're not following me already, make sure you follow me on TikTok at Conjur, C-O-N-J-U-R-0-R. Same thing on Kick. And guys, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure you sub up, leave a like. Oh, it's my return. I know a lot of you probably don't even know who the fuck I am, but that's okay. You about to. But we back. We back, gang.